there was a RAND report from the RAND Foundation years ago comparing parochial schools in New York City with public schools. The parochial schools had no money, but they had discipline. And the public schools were awash with money, but they failed. Who sent children to college? The parochial schools. Didn't matter, though. The mother was this and the father was that. The kid went to college. But the public schools failed. Why? So the RAND report said that they went into the public schools, and they asked the principal, what are you doing? What is your goal here? What is your plan? He says, I don't know. We don't have any plans. We just want kids to feel good about themselves and understand civil rights. In other words, you sit all day in the inner cities, you talk about civil rights. Don't let people push you around. And they grow up. No one's going to push me around. I'm not going to do what my boss tells me. I'm not going to study. I'm not going to do my homework. And I'll end up this. I'll end up with drugs because no one's going to tell me not to take drugs either. As long as we ignore this, we will never solve the problem. Again, the children went to parochial school. And they knew that if they fool around, the parochial schools in those days, you didn't fool around. And they didn't. And they went to college. They learned discipline. But in the public schools, oh, the poor dears, you mustn't hit them. Oh, no. Oh, no. That's barbarianism. So barbaric to hit a child. Two children. One child, he goes to a school, and they said, don't fool around here, do your work. Kids opens his mouth, and the teacher gets a smack in the face. Didn't break his teeth, didn't break his bones, a smack in the face. The kid survives it. The kid learns to be a human being, he graduates, he goes on, he gets a job, and he has a family, he's a human being, he has a good life. And the other school, oh dearie, if you want to talk back to the teacher, we have to consult the psychologist what we did wrong that you decided to become a wild kid. It's obviously our fault, but you please put up with our errors and our mistakes until we can somehow improve ourselves to make you happier so you don't tell us the horrible things you just finished saying to us. There was a fellow who teaches chemistry in New York City. He says they had a bunch of kids there. They didn't know anything. He is told, pass them. Pass them. If you're black, you pass. You pass chemistry. You don't know anything. You pass. And a kid learns that. If I'm black, I'll pass chemistry. And then he grows up. If I'm black, I'll get a job. I'll get paid. But it doesn't work like that. That's the end. So my response to Bob Herbert is that writing about the problem without addressing the idealism that destroyed blacks is a very frustrating thing, and it gets you nowhere. And as long as we have the Bob Herberts in the world who refuse to recognize who destroyed blacks, it was the idealisms of the liberal establishment, the educational establishment, that went away from biblical ideas to give a kid a smack in the face when he doesn't behave. And turn it into a criminal behavior. If a teacher smacks a kid today, he can go to jail. I don't know if he'll go to jail so fast, but that's a criminal act. That's child abuse. And the kids know it. And they terrify the teachers, and the end is they turn it to people that can't be married and can't succeed in life. So we are destroying children with goodness and liberal ideas. Oh, dearie, how can we make you happy? And in New York City, they're pouring billions of dollars into the children. Does it do any good? How can it do any good? A good smack in the face. Now, that's not a civilized thing to say. A good smack in the face puts the kid on the road. He knows he doesn't fool around. Chasel shifter, sonny, but no, you hold back the stick, you destroy this child. And those children raised with discipline, and they know what they must do, and they're not big shots. A kid is not a big shot. A kid is there to learn, to respect. Doesn't learn to respect, and he doesn't know what it is to be a kid, to learn and accept, and he's busy me, and he's being taught me. So then you have these kind of statistics, and even if you don't have all these statistics in certain communities, even communities where people don't have all these hideous statistics, as long as the children are being taught me, they can't be me. See, the marriages don't work and all the problems with kids. All of this is from the failures of the educational establishment to understand that the biblical ideas that a kid must be a kid, a child must be a child, he must be disciplined and taught to respect his elders and respect his teachers. If you don't have that, you have what Bob Herbert is talking about. This is Rabbi David Idenson, author of the book Secret of the Scale on Marriage and Human Relations. Our website is secretscale.com.